Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's video we are going to see some designing problem based on wide bandpass filter and narrow bandpass filter. So let's begin with the topic. Bandpass filter is basically a filter which is used to pass only a particular band of frequency, and it rejects or attenuates all the frequencies beyond that band. Therefore, in case of bandpass filter, there is one pass band and two stop bands. Based on the pass band, there are two types of frequencies, that means FH and FL. Now, the bandpass filter is basically get divided into two types, wide bandpass filter and narrow bandpass filter. This classification is typically based on the value of Q. If value of Q is less than 10, then filter comes under category of wide bandpass filter. But if value of Q is greater than 10, then filter comes under category of narrow bandpass filter. As value of Q get increased, the bandwidth is get reduced because Q is equals to FC upon bandwidth, where FC is the center frequency and bandwidth is nothing but the difference between higher frequency and lower frequency. So as the bandwidth and Q factor are inversely proportional to each other, therefore as the value of Q get increased, bandwidth is get reduced and we will get more and more sharper frequency response. So in case of narrow bandpass filter, the value of Q is higher as compared to wide bandpass filter. Now let's understand the designing process of wide bandpass filter. We know that in case of wide bandpass filter, the circuit consists of first order high pass filter cascaded, that means connected in series with first order low pass filter. So while designing, we need to design high pass filter as well as low pass filter, which is of first order. But the designing of filter is different from other circuits. So we need to follow certain steps during designing. We need to consider FH, FL, then various values of component, some values we need to assume, and they are in certain range. So let's understand the designing process of wide bandpass filter. So the designing process involves, the first step is select cutoff frequency FH for low pass filter and calculate values of R dash, C dash. Select C dash below 0.1 microfarad, and therefore R dash is now equals to 1 upon 2 pi FH into C. First, either you design high pass filter or low pass filter, but depending upon which filter we are designing, we need to consider FH and FL value. If it is a low pass filter, then we need to consider the value of higher frequency, that means FH, and if it is a high pass filter, then we need to consider the value of low frequency, that is FL. In this case, the values of component are get differentiated by using a dash symbol. Therefore, in case of low pass filter, all the components having a dash symbol like C dash, R dash. The value of capacitor is required to be selected in a such a way that it should be less than 0.1 microfarad. Based on the FH value and capacitor value, we are going to calculate the value of R dash by using a formula, that is 1 upon 2 pi FH into C dash. The second step is select cutoff frequency FL, which is usually given in the problem, and assume value of C. Find value of R is equals to 1 upon 2 pi FL into C. Now this process is basically for the process of designing of high pass filter, because in case of high pass filter, the cutoff frequency here is denoted by FL. The next step is find voltage gain. AVFT is equals to AVF1 into AVF2. As the wide bandpass filter consists of first order high pass filter and first order low pass filter connected in series form, that means cascaded form, therefore the total gain is nothing but the product of gain of first order filter high pass and first order low pass filter. So that's why the total gain is nothing but the multiplication of gain of individual stage. Now the fourth step is assume AVF1 is equals to AVF2 is equals to 2 and calculate the values of RF, R1, RF dash and R1 dash. Here, specifically, the gain value is equals to 2 only if it is not given in the problem. But if it is given in the problem, then we need to consider that value only. And based on the value of gain, we need to calculate the values of R1, RF, R1 dash, RF dash for high pass filter and low pass filter respectively. Now, let's understand the designing process in detail by considering few examples. The statement of problem is, design wide band pass filter for FL equals to 100 Hz and FH equals to 1 kHz. Pass band gain is 4. Also calculate value of Q factor. State the effect of Q on the frequency response of filter. In some problem, they will mention that whether the type of filter is wide band pass or narrow band pass. But in some problem, they will give the value of Q, and based on the value of Q, we need to assume which type of filter it is. Now in this problem, here we need to calculate the value of Q, and two frequencies are given, which are nothing but FH and FL along with passband gain. So here we need to consider the value of passband gain and not need to take the value of passband gain as a 2. Now let's first write down given data and starts with the designing. Assume value of capacitor as 0.05 microfarad. Now let's calculate the value of R based on the assumed value of capacitor and given value of frequency. For that purpose, we need to use a formula. R is equals to 1 upon 2 pi fc into c. Therefore, R is equals to 1 upon 2 pi fl into c, which is equals to 1 upon 2 pi into 100 into 0.05 microfarad. So the value of R is equals to 31.83 kilo-ohms. Now next process is to design low pass filter, and therefore for that purpose assume value of capacitor as 0.01 microfarad. Now by this assumed value and along with the value of FH, we will calculate the value of R, that is equals to 1 upon 2 pi FH into C. Therefore, R is equals to 1 upon 2 pi FH into C, which is equals to 1 upon 2 pi into 1K into 0.01 microfarad. And therefore, we will get R as 15.9 kilo-ohms. Now in the problem, the gain of filter, that means the total passband gain, is given as 2. We know that in case of wide band pass filter, gain is nothing but the product of gain of high pass filter and gain of low pass filter. So first we will calculate gain of high pass filter, and on the basis of that we will calculate the values of RF and R1. So as gain given as 4, therefore we can say that the gain of high pass filter becomes 2 and gain of low pass filter becomes 2. Therefore the product becomes 4. So now let's first calculate RF and R1 value based on the gain of high pass filter. And as op-amp is used in non-inverting configuration, therefore gain of high pass as well as low pass filter is given by formula AVF is equals to 1 plus RF by R1. So first we will calculate the values of RF and R1 for high pass filter, and then we will calculate the values of RF dash and R1 dash for low pass filter. So for high pass filter, AVF 1 is equals to 1 plus RF by R1. The value of AVF 1 is equals to 2, which is equals to 1 plus RF by R1. Now let's assume value of R1 as 10 kilo ohms. So after substituting the value of 10 kilo ohms, we will get the equation as and we will get value of RF as RF is also equals to 10 kilo ohms. So let's calculate the value of RF dash and R1 dash by assuming value of R1 dash and gain of filter, that is equals to 2. AVF 2 is equals to 1 plus RF dash upon R1 dash. As AVF 2 is also equals to 2, which is equals to 1 plus RF dash upon R1 dash. Now assume we can take same value of R1 dash as R1, that is equals to 10 kilo ohms, or else we can take some different values. So here I am assuming R1 dash is equals to 10 kilo ohms only. Therefore, RF dash is also equals to 10 kilo ohms. So this is how we can calculate the values of various components which are required to build a circuit of high pass filter and low pass filter. And when we combine these two circuits, we will get the output, that means a wide band pass filter. We know that in case of wide band pass filter or in case of narrow band pass filter, the value of Q increases or decreases the width of bandwidth. Therefore, as the value of Q is get increased, the bandwidth is get reduced and the frequency response becomes more and more sharper. So we can say that if the value of Q increases, frequency response gets sharper and bandwidth get reduced. This is the effect of Q on the frequency response. So we can write trace of frequency response as Q is equals to FC divided by bandwidth. So on the basis of this relationship, we can say bandwidth is get reduced. As bandwidth is get reduced, the frequency response becomes more and more sharper. Now let's move to the second problem related to the designing of wide bandpass filter. The statement of problem is, identify bandpass filter for Q equals to 3, gain equals to 5, FC equals to 1 kHz, and draw frequency response for the design filter. Now here only value of Q, gain and FC is given, value of FH and FL is not given, and we need to design a bandpass filter which is having value of Q that is equals to 3. We know that when value of Q is less than 10, then the filter comes under the category of wide bandpass filter, and therefore the type of filter used over here is wide bandpass filter, which consists of first order high pass filter and first order low pass filter. Now the first thing is we need to calculate the values of FH and FL on the basis of FC and Q value. So first we will write a given data, FC equals to 1 kHz, Q equals to 3, and gain given is equals to 5. Now we know that there is a relationship between Q and bandwidth and FC, and the relationship is given by Q is equals to FC upon FH minus FL, where FH is the frequency of low pass filter and FL is the frequency of high pass filter. Now let's substitute the values and find out values of FH and FL. So here Q is equals to 3, 1 kHz, FH minus FL. So we will get FH minus FL as, so FH minus FL is equals to 333.333. Now we know that there is a relationship between FC and FHFL, and the relationship is, now here by squaring both the side we get the equation as FC square is equals to FH into FL. Therefore FH into FL, we have the value of center frequency as 1 kHz, so squaring of that is equals to 1 into 10 raised to 6. Now we have the equation, that is FH minus FL, which is equals to 333.33. So let's consider that equation for calculating FH and FL. So we can say that FH minus FL is equals to 333.33. So we can convert the equation in the form FH is equals to 333.33 plus FL. Now let's substitute this value in the equation. Therefore we will get FH as 333.33 plus FL into FL equals to 1 into 10 raised to 6. Now when we solve this equation, we will get value of FL as, so when we solve the equation by using quadratic equation, we will get value of FL as 847.13 Hz or 1180.46 Hz. Now therefore from these two values we need to consider the less value of FL, and here we are considering value of FL as 847.13 Hz. Now with the help of this FL value we can calculate the value of FH, as FL should be less than FC. Therefore consider FL equals to 847.13 Hz. As value of fc given in the problem is 1 kHz. Therefore, we need to consider the value of fl, which is below 1 kHz. Now, let's calculate the value of fh by using equation fh equals to 333.33 plus fl. So, fh is equals to 333.33 plus, here we are taking value of fl as 847.13. Therefore, fh is now equals to 1180.5 Hz. Now we have values of both fh as well as fl. So now the next step is we need to assume the value of c and c dash, and we need to design low pass as well as high pass filter. So let's first design high pass filter. Now let's first design high pass filter and then low pass filter, because the wide band pass filter consists of combination of first order high pass filter first and then first order low pass filter. Now here we are assuming value of capacitor as 0.005 microfarad, and here we need to consider the value of frequency as fl. With the help of these two value, we will calculate the value of R by using formula 1 upon 2 pi fl into C. Now let's substitute the value of fl and C to calculate R value. So the value of fl is 847.13 and capacitor as 0.05 microfarad. So when we solve this equation, we will get R value as R equals to 3.757 kilo-ohms. Now these two are the components which are acts as the RC network for first order high pass filter. Now next step is to calculate the values of RF and R1 based on the gain of filter. Now in the problem, the gain is given as 5, but we know that the gain is nothing but the product of gain of high pass filter and gain of low pass filter. For simplicity purpose, we will always consider AVF1 is equals to AVF2, and therefore the total AVF is nothing but the AVF square. So here gain of high pass filter is considered as root 5. So now as op amp is connected in non-inverting configuration, so we will use formula 1 plus RF by R1. Therefore, AVF1 is equals to 1 plus RF by R1. Now, after assuming the value of R1 as 10 kilo ohms, we can calculate the value of RF. Therefore, as root 5 is equals to 2.236 equals to 1 plus. Now assume R1 equals to 10 kilo ohms. Now this is how we can design a high pass filter. Now next step is to design a low pass filter, and for that same process we need to follow, but instead of using capacitor value as 0.05 microfarad, we are going to use the value of capacitor as 0.01 microfarad, and fh equals to 1180.5 Hz. Now let's calculate the value of R by using formula 1 upon 2 pi fh into C. So here value of R is obtained as 13.48 kHz. Here we are taking R as R dash. Now next step is to find out the value of RF dash and R1 dash. Here also we consider gain of low pass filter as root 5, as it is a product of gain of high pass filter and low pass filter. So and assume value of R1 dash as 10 kilo ohms. So we use the same formula, that is AVF2 is equals to 1 plus RF dash upon R1 dash. Here we are assuming R1 dash as equals to 10 kilo ohms. Therefore, 2.236 as root 5 equals to 1 plus RF dash upon 10 kilo ohms. So we will get value of RF dash as, so RF dash is equals to 12.36 kilo ohms. So this is how, on the basis of only value of Q, FC and passband gain, we can calculate the values of FH, FL, and we can design low pass as well as high pass filter for wide band pass filter. In the problem, we also need to draw a frequency response for the same filter. So as the frequency response depends upon the value of Q is given as 3, that is less than 10. Therefore, it is a wide band pass filter, and therefore the frequency response is obtained as, on x-axis we are taking frequency, on y-axis we are taking gain, and The passband is now wider because gain of filter is equals to 5 and Q factor is less than 10, that is equals to 3. Therefore, the filter circuit or the filter frequency response consists of wide passband and two small stop band. So I hope you understand the problem of designing of wide bandpass filter. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikira. Subscribe Ikira. Thank you.